Hi everyone, Anthony Morganti here. Yesterday I received an email from a photographer who told me that they recently joined a camera club and went to their first meeting. And during the meeting, the photographers were showing their work, and one of the photographers mentioned that for one of their images, they used luminosity masking in Photoshop, and they told me that everyone there seemed to know what luminosity masking was all about, and they were new, a little bit shy, a little bit intimidated, and they didn't feel comfortable asking them what luminosity masking was. So they emailed me. So in today's video, I'm going to give you the very basics of luminosity masking, like luminosity masking 101. And I'm going to show you how you could use it in your post-production to help you when you're editing your images. Now, first of all, luminosity masking works great on images that have a lot of dynamic range, like a sunset. You have these very bright areas, and you have some relatively dark areas. With luminosity masking, you could target those specific areas. So you could target like the brightest areas and do editing just to that, or maybe you want to target the darker areas and do editing just to that. And with luminosity masking, you could actually very easily do that. Now, before I begin, I do want to mention that I'm in what is called the photography workspace. You may find it easier to follow along at home if you set your Photoshop up to the photography workspace. To do that, go up to Window, down to Workspace, and over and down to Photography. Now, have the image opened up into Photoshop. I haven't done anything to it. You can see over here on the Layers panel, it's right here, background layer. Nothing's been done. The first thing you should do is duplicate the background layer. Hit Command or Control J to do that. And during the video, if I say Command, that's on a Mac. Control is on a PC. So we duplicated the background layer. Now we're ready to get our first luminosity mask. I want to select the highlights, the brightest parts of the area, the image, and I want to warm those up. So I wanted to do some editing just to that highlight, the highlights. I want to warm them up. So to do that, what we're going to do is we're going to go to Channels. This is why if you're in the photography workspace, it may be easier for you to find the Channels tab. It's right here. And you can see we have red, green, and blue, and at the top we have the RGB channel. To get the luminosity mask of the brightest parts of the image, all you need to do is hold in the Command or Control key, and then click right on that little thumbnail that's next to RGB once. Just click once, and you'll get a selection. Now, it looks like a haphazard selection, but this is actually a selection of the brightest parts of the image. Now, go back to Layers. Now, to warm this up, I'm going to use a specific adjustment layer. This one right here, it's called Photo Filter, and I'm going to click on it. And you can see once I do that, it automatically put on this warming filter. And if I put the density up, you could see how it's just affecting the brightest parts of the image. And I want to draw your attention also over to the Layers panel. And if you look at the mask, because we had that selection active on layer one, as soon as I laid down the adjustment layer, it created a mask automatically. And it's just masking away the midtones and the shadows and allowing the adjustment to only be applied to the highlights, the brightest part of the image. So again, we could come in and kick up the warmth. And you could choose a different filter here. They have different warming filters. You could try different ones out. Or if you wanted to cool it, for that matter, you could use a cooling filter. But I think I'm going to go with that default warming filter right there. And that's fine. All right, now it's kind of dark, isn't it? So especially those cliffs, those are very dark. I want to brighten those up. Now, I guess unfortunate thing about doing luminosity masking when you're getting your selection, you only could select the highlights, but you could add to it. So you could select the brightest parts, and then you could add to it, get a little bit more of the midtones, then add to it, get a little bit more of the midtones, then add to it and get a little bit more of the midtones, then start to approach getting into the shadows. But before you do that, you would basically select all of the highlights and all the midtones, and then invert it. And once you invert it, you'll have just the shadow selected. And that's what we're going to do now to get those shadows selected so I could brighten them up. To do that, go back to this layer one right in the middle, and then go back to Channels. Now we're going to get our first luminosity mask by holding in the Command or Control key and again clicking on RGB. Now again, we have that same exact mask. We selected the highlights. But I want to add to this. I want to get some of those midtones selected as well. So hold in the Shift key along with the Command or Control key, and then click on the RGB thumbnail again. And now we're starting to select a bit more. Hold that shift key in along with the command or control key and click a third time. We're selecting even more. You can see we have the entire sky selected, except for maybe this corner over here. And, you know, it kind of looks weird, but you can see the cliffs are not selected. So let's do it one more time. Hold the shift key in and the command key in together on my Mac, control key on a PC, and click one more time. And now we have pretty much the whole sky selected, a lot of the beach selected, a lot of the water selected, those trees, whatnot, but that cliff is not selected. Now, if I do adjustments now, I won't be adjusting that dark cliff. I want to adjust the dark cliff. So what I need to do is invert the selection. To do that, hold in the shift key along with the command or control key and hit the I key, I for invert. And now it really inverted. It doesn't look it, but it did. And now go back to layers. Now, to brighten those up, I'm going to use a levels adjustment layer, and I'll click on that. You can see as soon as I clicked on that, it comes with a mask, and the mask is now like pre-done because I had that luminosity selection done. I had the marching ants all over the place, so it created the mask automatically. Now, to brighten those up, I'm going to go to this middle slider and move it to the left. You can see now it's brightening up those darker areas, not affecting the sky at all. See that? And just break them up a little bit. So that's it. That's really Luminosity Masking 101. I hope that helps you in your post-production. And like I mentioned at the top, it works best on images. And why you'd want to use it probably is on images that have a lot of dynamic range. So a lot of very bright areas, a lot of very dark areas. So you can target those areas independent of one another and do adjustments to them. Thank you, everyone who watches my videos. I really do appreciate it. I'll talk to you guys soon.